a work of music, literature, or art. These are the exact words that come to mind when composition is brought to the table. Musical composition can refer to an original piece of music, either a song or an instrumental piece, the structure of a music piece, or the process of creating or writing a new song or piece of music. You see? What I love about the world of music is its diversity. The genres that exist today are virtually infinite, spanning all the way from rap to classical and all the way in between. None of this could have happened, however, if it had not been for the art of composition. Music was a form of expression, a way of life. The music you listened to represented your rank in society. Therefore, people always wanted more music. This job of creating emotions and putting it to sound was given to composers. Some poor, some rich, they all spent their lives dedicated to music. While each composer has their own favorite way of putting thoughts and ideas to paper, the fundamentals of composing are the same. It is the arranging of notes in place of words in time with a beat. There are layers all coming together to make one big piece.
Hello, nice to meet you.
I am Joe Garza.
Joe Garza. And today I'm going to ask you a few questions about musical composition. So when someone says the word composition, what comes to mind?
Creating an art form through vibration of audio and expressing yourself through the form of music.
Okay, now judging by your hat, which is quite beautiful there, very artistic, what is your favorite form of music?
Metal.
Metal. And do you compose music for that style?
I indeed do. I am the leader, vocalist, and rhythm guitarist of a band called Zirconium. I have worked with other solo artists and other bands as well. I was recently indoctrinated as the guitarist, bassist, and keyboardist for a depressive suicidal black metal band known as Volper. And yeah.
And so, have you written any songs for that before?
I indeed have. I have written a total of, I believe, 32 songs, but I only release like one out of every five I write.
Alright, so if you could quickly and just kind of briefly describe the process of that so we can get a feel for what it's like to create a song like that. What is your process usually?
The process for writing a song is extremely different for everyone. The way I do it is I find inspiration, I act on it immediately, and I write a song in like 5 or 10 minutes tops. And I'm able to hear how everything comes around, comes alive with it. Like, I'm able to hear the guitar and the drums and everything else with it just by writing down the lyrics. And I'm able to get on my guitar and just play by ear until I find the sound that I want.
Interesting. And do you write down, how do you write down music? Do you just record it over and over and do samples, or do you use sheet music?
I write by ear, so I record over and over.
All right, cool. Thank you very much.
The process of putting notes to paper has become easier as technology has developed. In the earliest days, scores only had one handwritten copy for each instrument. Since then, technology has given us the tools to produce music quicker and more accurately.
Thank you.
From one genre, we now move to an entirely different one. The neoclassical or classical style of composition was one of the first introduced to the world and helped develop how we look at music. Without the earliest composers, many forms of music we enjoy today would not exist. Hello, nice to meet you.
Hello.
What is your name?
John.
And you are a composer.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when someone says the word composition, in the musical sense, what instantly comes to your mind?
It's the creation of music. So putting together musical thoughts and constructing a whole of a piece for different styles, of course, of composition.
If you had to sum up the style of music you compose for, what would that be described as?
I guess it would go under neoclassical, more the newer style, because the neoclassical music came about with Stravinsky and also with Prokofiev, but I still use those what would be considered classical forms, so sonata form, rondo, ternary, and so on.
What inspired you to start composing?
Actually, it was Mozart. I had listened to his music when I was 11. I discovered it, and I asked my mom. I said, "I really like this. Can I get more of this?" And she said, "Sure." So we took a trip to the store and got his piano concertos number 23 and 27. That was my first CD, and of course that was a long time ago. But after listening to that, I was like, wow, it just blew my mind.
Now, what was the first piece you ever wrote? Do you remember it?
I do. Actually, I could play it from memory. It's a little piece for piano, and it's very short, and it's a piece that will probably remain unpublished because it's lacking experience.
Mm-hmm.
But it's good for that memory.
Now, have you ever been to one of these performances of
your
music?
Yes. So, when you study composition at the collegiate level, you're actually required to put on recitals of your music. Yeah. So it's very, very rewarding to be able to sit in the audience and to hear your music performed.
Well, thank you very much for talking with me, Mr. Pacheco. It was great talking to you, great hearing about your opinions on composition, and it's just great to talk to another composer so I can further my composition abilities. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Music has been an important tool from its creation until today and onward to tell stories of both joy, sadness, and all the way in between. Music won't be going anywhere anytime soon, so it's up to the modern-day composers to continue this beautiful art form. As the great film composer Hans Zimmer once said, "If something happened where I couldn't write music anymore, it would kill me. It's not just a job. It's not just a hobby. It's why I get up in the morning." And with these parting words, the composers of today return to their studios and continue the tradition of sculpting culture with their music.
Thank you.